Hi! Today, Octoparse is gonna show you how to extract and monitor stock prices from Yahoo Finance. Okay, let's get started. The new Octoparse 8.2 interface is very intuitive. Once you copy and paste a URL into the address bar, it automatically gets started in parsing the web page and guesses what content you want to extract. In this case, we are going to enter the most active stock URL from the Yahoo Finance. After you paste the URL, click Start button and wait for a little bit while it's loading. Before we move on to next steps, let's find out the reasons for scraping stock prices. Why do we want to scrape stock prices? Well, when you constantly extract a stock price and continuously feed the data into your research and data models, you can then train your algorithm with your machine learning code that later gives you more accurate and profitable advices in the investment market. As you might have known, one of the applications of Octoparse is price monitoring. Not only does it track and monitor prices on a page, but it also extracts raw data from your competitors and scrapes real-time data within a few mouse clicks. With the auto detection feature, it takes 4 steps to scrape and extract stock prices. When you see the link Switch Auto Detect Results, click it through a few times until you see the table of most active stocks are highlighted in the browser. We need to take care of the pagination option. Click the Edit link and select the Next Page button on the page to let Octoparse know where exactly the next button is. Click the Confirm button once you have selected the next button. Uncheck the Add a Page scroll and generate a workflow. As you can see, a workflow is generated on the left-hand side. The next thing we need to set up is the pagination option. Hover the mouse cursor to the pagination bar and click the gear icon. Expand the exit loop panel and enter 2. This means we want the loop to quit after the next button on the web page has been clicked twice. Let's review our workflow. First, it executes go to web page. Next, it goes into a pagination loop, where it contains the real deal of extraction. You can see the extract data step that extracts where you have pre-selected. Then the loop will click the next button for you until the exit condition. Okay, let's save the task and click the Run button to fire off our scraping task. There are a few options where and when you want to run the task from. For this example's sake, select Run Task on your device. Okay, we can see extracted data started coming in and it will stop after 50 lines of data are extracted. When it is completed, click the Export Data button. Now, open up the saved spreadsheet and compare the data with the ones you previewed. Make sure the data looks good. as we scroll the spreadsheet, the last row is 51, which makes sense because the first row is the header. There you have it. In only a few minutes, we have extracted most active stocks from Yahoo Finance and saved the data to a spreadsheet. We have way much more to come regarding Octoparse and web scraping. If you like our channel, please give us a thumb up and subscribe. Thank you.